Donald Trump is backtracking on his alarming suggestion that injecting disinfectant could treat the virus. As his administration manages the fallout, America's toll ticked past 50,000 lives. Amelia Adams has more.
Putting his name to a bill to help the American economy, but it was the president's medical advice in the spotlight.
Now, I was asking a question sarcastically to reporters like you just to see what would happen.
Attempting to explain this comment from yesterday.
Disinfectant, where it knocks it out in a minute, 1 minute. And is there a way we can do something like that by injection inside?
But I was asking a sarcastic and a very sarcastic question to the reporters in the room about disinfectant on the inside. But it does kill it, and it would kill it on the hands, and that would make things much better.
The reaction was swift and incredulous, the president's words prompting the makers of Dettol to remind the public under no circumstances should disinfectant be administered into the human body. Emergency services in the state of Maryland put out an alert after receiving calls about disinfectant use.
When he gets new information, he likes to talk that through out loud and really have that dialogue.
5 weeks ago, 240 Americans had died after testing positive to COVID-19. Today, that toll is more than 50,000. Even so, businesses in Oklahoma and Georgia reopened with mixed emotions.
I got to pay rent and I got to pay my barber some money to help them out.
I do not think it makes sense to open these businesses way before the curve and before we hit the peak.
And there was more sobering economic news today. The US federal budget deficit tipped to more than triple to $3.7 trillion US dollars this year, levels not seen since the Second World War.
The country is a great place, and it's going to be greater than ever before. I really believe that.
After the disinfectant debacle, we may be hearing less from the president at the daily coronavirus briefings. Today, for once, he was not taking questions.
Mr. President, now the time for sarcasm.
In New York, Amelia Adams, Nine News.